Oh, what a good movie. On my block? Why is it recommending on my block?
This is our neighborhood.
Gentefied?
This is about Pop trying
what do these
survive?
Have to do with divorce?
Like this is our neighborhood.
Wait,
this is about Pop trying to survive.
Where are all the movies with Laura Dern?
This is about Pop trying to survive.
What is Charlie's problem?
I don't know. Need some flavor in his life. I'm gonna play on my block.
Oh, no, Gentefied is so good.
Babe, did you give our password to Pablo again? Oh my god. Babe, something's wrong with the Netflix.
We're so good at our jobs. You wanna get lunch?
Hey y'all, welcome to Go Off with Jess and Julissa. It's your girl Jessica Marie Garcia.
I'm Julissa Calderon, and I am so excited to be here. Welcome, y'all.
How good do you look right now?
I'm a Dominican Barbie today. That's what I am. I am obsessed. You look gorgeous, y'all. Netflix gave us a show. Jess, can you believe that?
A whole ass show. Like a whole ass show.
We got sketches. We got hot topics.
So many amazing things, and we are going to laugh a lot. And today we are going off on I Care a Lot.
And we do.
Woo! Jess, you ready to go off?
Oh, I'm ready to go off. Are you ready to go off?
Let's go off. It was like a roller coaster of emotions. Like, how did you feel about that shit?
Okay, listen, that bitch should have died so much earlier. I didn't know that I would watch a movie where I loved it, but hated the person you were supposed to be rooting for, and were rooting for the people that were supposed to be more evil than them.
Yo, but do you think this stuff like this happens in real life? Like, do you think
this is based off? Yes, oh hell yes. Oh my God, yes. Are you kidding me? Oh, if people can take money from people, they will find a way.
That makes me sad.
That's what hurt the most, is I was like, I wonder how much this actually happened.
First of all, I love old people. Like, I cursed out somebody in Publix in Florida one time because he was rude to this little old man who was just asking where the magazines were. So the fact that, like, this whole movie was this fucking woman, white woman, taking advantage of all of these older people.
I might never flat iron my hair again, because I swear every single time her hair was super straight and down, she did some evil shit.
It was like she gained power from the
heat. She's just looking at the mirror like, like I just see the smoke going to, what up? Because you know that shit was like stiff.
But I wish somebody would try to take my mama and put her ass in a home and take away her legal rights. I will kill someone. I'm going to jail. Do not mess with old people, because that's not okay.
People. That's so fun.
No, I'm sorry. That's it. Mm-hmm. I'm real cool unless you mess with my grandma's friends, or anybody in her age range. Do not play with us. Look at how we're just as angry as the guy in the beginning. But that goes to show like how brilliant of an actress that woman was.
Oh my God, Rosamund.
She nailed it.
Oh my God. Who was your favorite? Who did you love?
Well, besides Peter Dinklage, because I'm obsessed with him.
I was waiting for like a dragon.
I'm really sad that Peter Dinklage didn't like come through with his Game of Thrones head.
That would have been the only other like film, like that movie was everything, every genre. So all it needed was a dragon just so it could be like, oh, fantasy too? Okay, it's there.
We did that. Check.
Check.
Like I felt like Asa, obviously she's a Latina, so I'm gonna root for her. I also felt because she's a Latina, she had a little bit of the compassion in the movie. Like she was like, nah, like we shouldn't do this. We should run away. I don't want to get shot. All of the things that you're like, yes, you're smart, let's go. But instead, the other bitch want to tell her no.
Their chemistry. They on Instagram, they call each other wifey, and in interviews they call each other wifey. It's the cutest thing in the world.
I would love to play like a real villain, because I feel like people are like, people see me as like a villain on Gentefied, and I'm like, nah, I'm just speaking facts. I'm just being like the only real person trying to be for the community.
Okay, Julissa, let's say that you're Marla. Now, that man just came up to you and called you all to see you next Tuesdays and spit in your face. What would you do? I want a rundown.
Okay, so first, I would have been really cool, right? Because I know that clearly I ain't shit as Marla. But when he spit on me, I take that as the highest form of disrespect that any human can like input on any other human. Like, do not spit, do not do that. Like, you think I am scum. And although Marla is scum, and in this moment I am scum, you will not treat me as such. What about you, Jess?
I've been in a couple altercations.
What if somebody, what if a dude came up to you like that and was like calling you all of these things, but you are... Let's go.
Oh no, it does not take much. I'm like a little combative anyway. Like already, I'm always kind of looking for it.
Yeah.
I will never hit you first, but I will hit you last. Ooh. You know?
Talk on. Go off, girl. Go off. I think that anyone that's from Florida has been in an altercation. You know?
Yeah.
One or two or three or four or five.
Damn,
or
people
you know what? Don't talk about
wait,
that.
If
that's
the Florida ones don't count, I'm clear. I'm down to zero.
I was twerking on a stranger's car, like screaming at the top of my lungs in Spanglish. Sin zapatos to Uncle Luke. That's when I knew I hit rock bottom.
I don't think America has a place for these people.
Who the hell's walking up and down the road in their bare feet?
This is the hardest thing you'll ever do.
All my friends have two DUIs, and I don't even know if it's worth it.
I run the Far From Florida Recovery Center in Eugene, Oregon. We help former Floridians reintegrate back into normal society.
They provide answers and they provide a home. They provide someone to listen to them.
Supposedly.
With a D, supposedly.
Supposedly.
And going into that world is very terrifying.
You are from Florida.
No, I'm from Miami.
And where is Miami?
In Miami.
There's no patch or gum for PTFD. Post-traumatic Florida disorder. Now, what did we say 72 degrees was?
Winter?
Okay.
It's difficult also because you're not used to making your own decisions.
Purpose.
Publix.
What do you want, Samantha?
I want a pet manatee.
No.
I want to walk out of the club with no shoes on.
No.
I want to drive on the wrong side of the highway.
No, Samantha, what do you want?
I want to be far from Florida!
Cut the cameras.
Florida, Miami, I love you. I'm a 305 girl till I die.
Yeah, Orlando 407, don't hate me. I'll be back soon. I love Disney World.
Julissa, we got fan love.
I want to jump right into it. Let's just jump right into it. Do you have any advice about moving on from childhood friendships?
Ooh, I actually need this. Please give me some advice. Did I write that? I might have written that to you.
You know what's so interesting? I feel like it's okay to grow. And sometimes you're not growing. And it doesn't mean that you're growing differently in a bad mm-hmm. way, but I could be growing yeah. like this way, you're growing that way, and we just don't communicate or see the same way that we saw each other when we were children.
But I'm also that bitch, it's like, we might not have been talking for 3 years, but you can call me and I'll be at your door in 10 minutes.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, we don't have to communicate all the time, like, still know that I'm there for you. Like, that's different.
That's so perfect that you said that. Because I think that because people feel like, oh, we grew apart as friends and we're no longer speaking on this every day or every week level, whatever, that you're no longer gonna ever be there for me.
Right.
If I'm no longer cool with my childhood friend, I'm not gonna be there for her. And she calls me and she's like, I'm in some shit. I'm gonna be like, girl, when and where? When and where?
I'll get the shovel, like, let's go. Okay, this question hits my heart and my soul, and I know it's going to do the same to you. It says, how do you make peace with your body? It's so frustrating no matter what I do. I'm so fed up.
Mm.
Well, first of all, I just want to give you the biggest hug because, I mean, self-confidence is a daily struggle for, I think I can say, for everyone.
Mm-hmm.
The grass is never greener on the other side. This, if you think I look great, which I do, took a village. And confidence is also something I found in just being, just falling madly in love with who I am
mm-hmm.
in every respect. This body has been with you since day one. Worship this bitch.
And know that you really are one of one. There's no one built like you. I don't care if you have a doppelganger out there. It doesn't matter. You are built one of one, and who you are is a beautiful thing. So once you learn to embrace that, once you learn to love that, the confidence just exudes. I feel a little more confident about myself already.
Do you? You should, girl. You can't look like that and not just like, ooh, every day. I would walk by mirrors all the time if I were you. I would just be like, mm-hmm.
I do.
Yes, yes.
Oh my God, I had so much fun, Jess. Oh,
I could play with you all day, girl.
What a great first episode. Really, really and truly. All the fan questions, the sketches. Please come back, catch us next time. We will be talking about...
Moxie, you are going to love this movie, y'all. I can't stop talking about it. We got some real superstars in the making, so please come back and check out this episode because the sketches get even better too.
Until next time, go off.